It's just funny how you talked so much about you beating me, yet I won almost every game.
I may have went easy on you as to not hurt your feelings.
Right, I'm sure you did. I had fun tonight.
So did I.
And I put a smile on your face, so I should get some points for that.
You do. You get a lot of points.
You know, when you were taking your shots, I kept thinking about how good you look. Outbowling you was fun, but I was really looking forward to this.
Coming home?
Yeah, even looking at you right now. Why don't we... Sorry about that. Anyway, one sec.
Everything okay?
Shit, I have to go. I'm so sorry.
Seriously?
Yeah, but we'll hang out soon again, okay?
Wow.
You're thinking of Snow Dogs, the kitty flick. This is Snow Patrol, the band.
Your phone is driving me nuts.
I'm sorry, babe. I'll silence it.
He's making a joke. No, you weren't. Yeah, I was. You were dead serious. It was a joke.
So, how well do you know Chase?
The neighbor? Well, since he's only lived here a few days, I'd say not well at all.
It's just kind of funny how you made it seem like you never even spoke to him. Then I hear Ivory telling you to get at him or something.
And how did you hear that? Were you eavesdropping on us? Austin, what the hell?
What the hell? This is my house, and if a bitch...
Don't call her that.
She's a bad influence, Iris. I don't like you hanging around her.
She's my best friend.
Who encourages you to cheat on your husband. You can find better friends than that.
Do I complain about your scumbag friends who are always trying to drag you to the club every other night?
Yes! You complain a lot!
Look, I'm sorry that she came here and was rude to you. I already talked to her about it. It won't happen again.
It's not even about that. She's not good for you. I don't want you being her friend, period.
Wow, you have a lot of nerve. Do you know that?
As my wife, you should respect what I tell you.
Right, like you respected it when I asked you not to walk out on me?
We're past that. Stop bringing that shit up.
I'm not past it. Now, where the hell were you? Answer the damn question. Don't give me that.
Punished for being awkward. Wasting away, waking daily to the sound of you waving my failures in my face. You underestimate me.
Austin, open the door.
Are you gonna listen?
No, I'm not gonna stop seeing my best friend. That's ridiculous.
Then get the hell out of my face.
So you're just gonna shut me out? Really? This man, I swear.
Drinks, I'll think different. Maybe I can change my ways. Maybe I don't want to. Maybe I'll punch you. Maybe give me my own space.
He shuts me out, locks the door, and blasts the music. I back off. He's gonna have to come out eventually. And he does. An hour later, wearing his jacket, he walks right past me and heads towards the door. Where are you going?
Out.
Like hell you are?
My boy's already here. I should be back by 2.
Are you out of your fucking mind?
So you can have your friends, but I can't have mine.
I'm not saying you can't have friends, you idiot, but you shouldn't be leaving at 10 o'clock at night to go party when you have shit going on at home. We're supposed to be working things out. You know my issues with you leaving, you're gonna turn around and do it again?
I'm coming back in a little while. Chill out.
I don't care.
You just came home yesterday. Last thing you need to be doing is going out again. You're a married man. Act like it.
I feel so alone. I hate this feeling. I shouldn't have this feeling. How can I be married and alone? The one person I should be able to turn to when I'm feeling this way doesn't even want to be around me. I'm sitting on the couch watching Netflix, eating my sorrow away when I catch a glimpse of something outside my window. I move the blinds and see it's Chase stepping out onto his back porch and talking on the phone. The moon is full, the night is quiet, maybe I can use a little fresh air. I step outside and make my way to my backyard. I approach the fence separating our properties. Just as Chase ends his phone call, he notices me and steps down to meet me at the fence.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. What are you doing?
I thought I saw someone walking around in my backyard and I wanted to check it out.
Really?
No, I wanted to talk to you.
Okay.
I'm sorry for standing you up the other night. It's just...
Old boy came back. I know.
I really did try to meet you. There was just no way. I feel bad.
Don't. It's not a big deal. You have a good night.
Hey, wait a minute. Is everything okay?
Everything is fine. Isn't your husband inside waiting on you?
No, his friends came and picked him up and they went out. We were fighting, so he wanted to be spiteful.
I'm sure y'all work it out.
Maybe, maybe not. I'm starting to feel like I should have just taken your advice and not let him back in.
Yeah, but you didn't.
Are you sure you're not mad at me?
I told you I wasn't. We only just met, and what you do is your business. It has nothing to do with me.
Wow, okay. Well, I heard you had a date tonight.
I did.
How'd it go?
I had a good time. Ivory's a lot of fun. Kind of wild.
That she is, but... She is charming. Do you think you would go out with her again?
Would it bother you if I did?
No, of course not. Why would it? I mean, it's not like I want to date you or something. Not to say that I wouldn't. I mean, I'm not saying that I would date you either. I'm just saying I'm married and I couldn't even if I wanted to. But, I mean, that's not the only reason. I'm not saying I like you. I mean, I do like you, Chase. I mean... I like you as a friend, but if I wasn't married, what am I trying to say?
Relax. It's okay. I got what you're saying.
Don't laugh at me. You stare at me all intensely with those pretty brown eyes and I forget my own damn name.
I don't mean to. My bad.
The point is, you and Ivory are hanging out now. You and I can be friends even though Austin is back, but we just can never be best friends because apparently I'm not supposed to have those anymore.
Are we friends enough for you to walk next to me while I walk down the block? Or 3 feet behind me? Whatever makes you comfortable.
Oh, very funny. I guess for a minute. No more 2 a.m. conversations though. This has to be a short walk.
I destroy all my foes in silence. Enjoy, I'm at Pinavana. We can roll if you really wanna. Cause you were never alone.
It isn't short. Time gets away from us yet again as we get swept into our conversation, and I have to answer for it when I get home.
Where have you been?
When did you get home?
Answer the question.
I was outside.
You weren't outside when I came home.
I took a walk up the street. What's the problem? I'm supposed to just sit in the house waiting around till you decide to come home and spend time with me?
Why the hell would you be walking around in the middle of the night? I came home because I felt bad and I wanted to be with you, not them. And then I look out the window and see you coming back with this dude that lives next door.
So, Chase and I are cool. He happened to be out when I went outside. It's not that serious.
I've been home for 45 minutes and you've been gone this whole time. What the fuck were y'all doing? You know what? I'ma just go ask him.
Leave him alone.
No, I want to talk to him.
Don't go over there harassing him because you have issues. The problems that me and you are having have nothing to do with him.
Why the hell are you protecting him so hard, huh? Wait. Is that the reason you wanted to go outside so much the other night? To see him? I swear to God, Iris.
No, Austin. Chill out. Listen to me. I have not done anything wrong. I've been nothing but faithful since the beginning. Me and him have had a few conversations. That's it. I am not cheating on you. I have not cheated on you. Can you look me in the eye right now and say the same? Can you?
Starring Desiree Pickett as Iris Reed, Everett Drazounds Longston as Austin Reed, Ron Baker as Chase Reynolds, and Anissa Ortega as Ivory Young. Come back Thursday, June 22nd for episode 3 of Chain. Thanks for listening.